Guys, what's going on? I hope you guys are well. Guys, a lot of you have been asking me about a Calm Brook video. That is going to be uploaded tomorrow afternoon, so stay tuned for that one. I've got that recorded. I'm not releasing it for some reason. I don't know why, but that will be uploaded tomorrow around 5-6 o'clock. So stay tuned for that. I will upload it. I know you guys wanted me to do videos about that. I also do one with my brother as well. Basically what happened is we recorded a video which was about 30 minutes long, and the space on my phone ended because I had so many other videos on my phone, and that video ended up, you know, getting deleted, or it didn't record because my phone didn't have space, so I had to delete it. Unfortunately, it's just the way it was. It didn't upload, you know, it didn't upload, and I was like, oh man, I don't know what was going on. So I just thought I'll have to redo that video, man. It's really pissed me off because it was a long one as well, but we'll have to do it again, no worries. But guys, I've got some news about, remember we were talking about Canelo Macabu, and we were talking about the fact that, you know, is there going to be a rehydration clause, is all of that stuff was being talked about, and everybody was saying, oh well, you know, there's no way Canelo can have a rehydration clause, there's no way Canelo can do it at a catch weight. Well, apparently Eddie Reynoso has said that there's going to be no catch weight for that fight, and there's going to be no rehydration clause. And I think the reason why I think Eddie Reynoso knows that that fight, a lot of people are upset with it. If they were to put on a catch weight and a rehydration clause, I think it's just going to pee people off even more. So I can't see, you know, them putting a rehydration clause there. I can't see them doing it at catchweight, because I think Canelo would be confident of beating Macabu no matter what the weight. It's great news. I'm happy because I'm a Canelo fan, and I don't want Canelo to receive criticism, and he would have done. And I, to be honest, would have criticized him. Like I said to you guys, even though I'm a Canelo fan and I like his style, I like the fact that he takes on whoever, takes on champions, I speak the truth, as I said in my video yesterday, and fighting him at a catchweight or putting a rehydration clause on, I'm sorry to say, for me, look, Amir Khan's fighting Kell Brook, and I told you I'm going to do a video about that tomorrow. He's put in a catchweight, or 149, and he's also done a rehydration clause, and that's even worse because they're not champions. What that shows is obviously Amir's the A side, so he's putting on stipulations. And listen, at the end of the day, sometimes in the future, look, the reasons why the A side do this is because in the future nobody talks about catch weights, or nobody talks about the weight stipulations or rehydration clause. Some people do to, if they want to diminish a fighter, oh yeah, he put on rehydration clause, that wasn't the best, this, that and the other. But majority of the time, right, if you're the A side, you want all the advantage you can get. Canelo's moving up a lot of weight in fighting Macabu. He's moving, and people may say, well, Macabu's a bum, Macabu's not, but it's a lot of weight. What you got to understand is boxing's not easy. Like, I think a lot of people seem to think boxing's very easy. And this is why I get very angry over the years, when I used to get angry when people used to mock Amir Khan, because it used to really anger me, because a lot of these guys don't know how hard boxing is. They think it's easy. That's what Canelo Alvarez's trainer, Eddie Reynoso, said, that, you know, no world champion is easy. It's not easy to become a world champion. Hit the nail on the head. It's not easy to become a world champion. If that was easy, then anyone, me, you, anyone could be a world champion. Anyone would be a world champion boxer if it was that easy. It's not. It requires a lot of skill, and it requires a lot of talent and a lot of ability. Believe me, in any sport, to reach the top, and nowadays I know there are some weak world champions, but even them are good. They may not, some of them, there are weak champions because there's so many belts, but even those are not poor fighters. They can fight, right? Obviously, we have, for me, world-class fighters. We have elite fighters. We have guys that are fringe world level, but even the fringe world level guys are good. Even the gatekeepers are good, you know? So I feel like a lot of the time, you know, a lot of boxing fans can be quite disrespectful and not give certain fighters the credit they deserve. And Macabu, although he would be a massive underdog, and a lot of people seem to think that Canelo's going to walk through him, believe me, that's not an easy fight. When you're moving up that kind of weight class, or moving up that much in weight, the other guy is naturally a bigger guy. It becomes a very dangerous situation. You know, it's not easy. It becomes a very, very dangerous situation. It becomes dangerous. Very dangerous. You know, so anything's possible. Anything's possible. When you're fighting when you're fighting and moving up that many weights, it becomes a dangerous situation. So Canelo Alvarez, for me, you've got to take your hat off. You got to take your hat off and give him respect. You know, all the hate and all the, oh, he's ducking, he's this, that, and the other. We just need to leave that nonsense to one side. Mr. Canelo Alvarez is taking on champions at cruiserweight. That needs to be commended. And also, what you got to understand is, I think Canelo, he doesn't need to put on rehydration clauses and hydration. But I can understand why he would want to do it, especially if he's fighting an elite cruiserweight. Because here's the thing, and I think Mike hit the nail on the head in the live stream, that what is such a big deal when if a guy is moving up to cruiserweight and fighting an elite guy, right, and he's the A side, he's the dominant guy, why shouldn't he put some advantages in his favor? Because the other guy's got all the advantages. He's bigger, he's stronger, he's, you know, he's the bigger guy, you know, he's got all the physical advantages. So why can't Canelo put on some stipulation, especially like Makabu's not an elite guy, he's a good world-class cruiser, he's a decent cruiserweight, right? Bradis is an elite cruiserweight. So Canelo going up against Bradis, now you're talking, that becomes dangerous. That becomes, you know, Canelo might even go into that fight as an underdog against Bradis. You know, so are you trying to tell me that Canelo should put on no... Now, if Canelo goes to heavyweight, there isn't no stipulations. There isn't anything at that weight. You can't put on any stipulations, you know, because it's heavyweight. Those guys are too big. But at cruiserweight, these fights are happening at weight classes. You can't be above a certain weight on the way, you know, when you're weighing in, right? But why can't Canelo put in a rehydration clause? Why can't... Because at the end of the day, Canelo's giving you a great fight. If he was to, for example, fight Bradis, he's giving you an unbelievable fight against a guy that's way bigger than him, a very skilled cruiserweight. It's a dangerous fight for him. So because Bradis has got all the advantage, for example. So by putting on these stipulations, it gives Canelo an even play. It makes it more of an even playing field. Because otherwise, it's not an even playing field. Because the chances are, the bigger man, if he's got all the advantage in weight, size, everything, then Canelo's got very little scope. He's got very little to work. He might be elite. He might be way better fighter than Bradis. But at the end of the day, Bradis is an unbelievable fighter. And he's bigger. You know, it becomes dangerous. So, like, I remember Mike making that point that why, when you are moving up so much in weight class, the other guy's got such a big advantage anyway. By you putting on a rehydration clause or you putting in a catch weight when you're fighting an elite guy, I don't have a problem with that, because at least it's still hard for him. It's still going to be very difficult. I'm against catch weights. I'll be honest with you, I'm against catch weights altogether. I'll tell you why I'm against catch weights, because I feel like Canelo shouldn't be fighting for a cruiserweight title at a catch weight. That's wrong. Because the cruiserweight limit is a certain amount. Like, I don't mind him fighting Bivol at 172, but you can't be fighting for the light heavyweight title. That's wrong for me. Personally, for me, that's wrong. And I think the reason why he was looking to fight Bivol at 172 is because he wanted to be undisputed at 168. So he didn't want to move up too much and then move back down, because he probably thought it would be very difficult for his body. I'm against catch weights, guys. I'm going to put that out there. I ain't so much against rehydration clauses. I'm not so much against rehydration clauses, if I'm totally honest with you. Especially when it's a guy like Canelo moving up to cruiserweight to fight, you know, Makabu. And if Makabu's going to blow up to 220 pounds, you know, that's a very big unfair advantage. You know, he might be 20, 25, 30 pounds heavier than Canelo. Because in my opinion, Canelo, even on fight night at cruiserweight, is probably going to be no more than 190. You know, he's probably going to be what he weighs in is probably going to be what he fights at. You know, whereas these guys like Bradis might go up to 220. You know, who knows, like, what they might weigh in after they rehydrate. Because these are naturally bigger guys. So for Canelo to put a rehydration clause there, I have no problem with it. And I have no problem with, like, if Andrade was to go to fight Beterbiev, and Andrade's not the A-side, so Andrade's not the A-side to any situation. He's not a big enough name. His name doesn't hold enough power like Canelo. But if, for example, he went up and just say he was the A-side and he was to put on a rehydration clause to Beterbiev, I have no problem with that, because Andrade is daring to be great. So I have no problem with him putting on a rehydration clause. I have no problem with that. When you're a smaller guy and you're putting on a rehydration clause for a guy that's naturally massive, I don't really have a problem with that. Especially when you're the A side. when you're the one that's, you're bringing the money and you're the one that's bringing all the, you know, the name and the fame or whatever. Like, I don't have a problem with that. I genuinely don't have a problem with that. You know, and that's just the way I see it. But in terms of this, I think Canelo is great that he's not going to have a rehydration clause and there's going to be no catch weights. It's brilliant. Brilliant because I personally think that Canelo beats him. It doesn't matter whether he has a catch weight or a rehab, whatever. He'll beat him anyway. So you might as well not give people an opportunity to, you know, take away your credit. Now, Canelo don't care what people say, because he's a guy that's accomplished a lot and he's achieved a lot. He don't care what people are saying. But the point I'm trying to make is, why give people an opportunity? If you're going to fight for a cruiserweight title, fight at the proper weight. I'm against that. Like, I will be honest with you. Like, if you're fighting for the middleweight title at 155, I'm sorry, I'm against that. So when Canelo was doing it and when he fought Amir Khan for the middleweight title at 155, and I don't care whoever's done it in the past, I don't like it. Because for me, you're not respecting weight classes. You, like, for me, a middleweight weight limit is 160. Super middle, 168. Like, once you start, that's nonsense. You know, that's, that for me, like, yeah, you, okay, you should fight at one. You should, if you want to fight at 155, that's your choice, you know? But the other guy should be allowed to fight at 160 if it's a middleweight title. Because it's the middleweight champion. The middleweight champion and the middleweight title is always contested at 160. One guy, or it doesn't matter how big somebody is, shouldn't be bigger than the rules of boxing or bigger than boxing, you know? And that's how I feel about it. And I feel like when in boxing, the problem is when a guy gets so big, when a guy becomes so massive, when a guy becomes a superstar and the world of boxing need him, I feel like a lot of rules can be bent and a lot of rules can be twisted because of the fact that the guy has become such a big star. I don't like that so much because I feel like the fighter is getting too much control. And I think there needs to be like a governing body in place where the fighter, although, yeah, fair enough, he's getting a lot of money. But when the fighter starts controlling and you know, start dictating where he's fighting at, I don't like that. You see, the WBC and all that should put a stop to that. That a fighter can't control what weight he fights at. If you're fighting for the middleweight title, it has to be 160. Fighting for a cruiserweight title, it has to be 200 or 190, whatever it is. That's how I feel about it, you know. The rehydration clause, not so much. Because like I said, if a guy's moving up, flipping three weight classes and he's fighting a bigger guy, putting on a rehydration, and he's the A side and he's daring to be great, he's putting on a wrist, then I don't mind because it makes it more of an even playing field. A catch weight is not an even playing field because the other guy might not be able to make the weight. He might be doing damage to his health. You know, but he might be doing it because, oh, I'm fighting Canelo. It's a big payday, so I'll just make... You know, but that I don't like anyway. I don't like that. Just being brutally honest with you guys. But so when Canelo was fighting for the middleweight title at 155, I wasn't so much of a fan of that. I'm going to be honest with you. I would prefer him to fight at 160. And the crazy thing is, eventually he did go to 160 and he did fight at 160. You know? And a lot of people at that time were saying, well, the reason why Canelo's not going to 160 is because he's avoiding Golovkin. He don't want to fight at 160 because he knows he has to fight Golovkin. In the end, he eventually went and he fought Golovkin at 160, which was, you know, like I said, two amazing fights. But yeah, I'm mainly for a guy, because Canelo then fought Khan, then he vacated his title at middleweight, and then he went down and fought Liam Smith for the 154-pound title. Then after that, did he move up to 160? I think he did. But for me, Canelo wasn't really a light middleweight at that point. He was a proper middleweight. He should have been at middleweight. That's just my opinion. But leave your thoughts, guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Canelo Alvarez looks like he will fight Makabu at the proper weight. But leave your thoughts. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. And guys, remember to please like, share, subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.